Hello ladies and welcome back to my channel, I'm Urania and this is the channel for femininity and for self-improvement. Even though the world is slightly getting back to normal, virtual meetings are here to stay. But what is the proper etiquette? Well, in today's video, that is exactly what we're going to focus on. We will start today's video off with simple ways that you can look put together in a virtual meeting. And I will also give you some outfit inspiration, followed by video call etiquette, the do's and the don'ts. Ladies, without further ado, let's get straight into today's video. It is very important that you take pride in your appearance, also when you work from home. So now we're going to look at some easy tips that can help you to look good in your next virtual meeting. My first tip is to take morning showers. If you were used to taking showers in the morning when you were going to the office, you should definitely keep doing that. I love taking my morning shower because it always helps me to feel awake, feel energized, and feel refreshed. Number two, your skincare routine. Take some time in the morning to do your skincare. Put on a serum, your moisturizer, use your tonics. It's really going to make your skin feel refreshed and you're going to look good. Number three, put on some light makeup. You don't have to go with a full face of makeup, but definitely do what works for you. I like to go with some light makeup when I have a virtual meeting. I would put on some concealer under my eyes. I would fill in my eyebrows. And I would put on some lip gloss or a tinted lip balm. I wear eyelash extensions, but if I would not have my eyelash extensions, I would put on some light mascara. Tip number four, to look good in a virtual meeting. Do your hair. Make sure that your hair is done. You can have your hair loose, you can put it in a ponytail or in a bun. It doesn't matter as long as it looks neat. Number five, make sure that your nails are done and that they look neat. Especially when you are the person that's presenting in the video call, you might talk with your hands and people can see, your colleagues or your clients can see that your nails are not done. It's not a good look. So make sure that your nails are done. And also for yourself, I personally cannot stand it when I'm typing and I see that my nails look chipped. I cannot stand it. So I always have to fix my nails then. So ladies, make sure that your nails look neat. Number six, earrings or a necklace, or both. I think that something so small as a dainty necklace or earring can make you look so much better. I always try to put on earrings when I have a virtual meeting, and sometimes I have on a necklace or I wear both, but definitely one of the two. You can go with a necklace or an earring that looks dainty or minimal, and it will definitely elevate your look. And number seven on how you can look good in a virtual meeting is to wear appropriate clothes. I think it's very important that we feel comfortable when we are in our own home. But we also need to look presentable. So comfortable and presentable is the way to go. I will now show you a couple of examples. And ladies, those were some simple ways that you can look put together, but also feel comfortable in your next virtual call. Now that you look put together and presentable, it is time for us to look at the do's and don'ts of a video call. What is proper video call etiquette? Number one, test your technology. You want to be sure that all your technology is working fine before you sign into the meeting. Make sure that you check your software, your microphone, your video and audio quality. This is especially important when you are using a new type of software or when you are logging in from a new computer. Number two, sit in a well-lit room. Make sure that you are sitting in a room that has enough light and that you are facing the light source. You want to face the light source, So when you are using natural lights, you want to sit in front of the window. Number 3, be punctual. Just like a normal meeting, you need to be on time. When you have a meeting at the office, you will stop working ahead of time and give yourself some time to prepare for your meeting. Go to the restroom, get some coffee, and then walk to the room. What a lot of people are doing when it comes to virtual meetings is that they continue working until the last minute and then log in, not giving themselves enough time to get out of work mode. What you can do is 10 minutes before your meeting starts, stop working. Take 5 minutes for yourself and get some coffee, go to the restroom and prepare yourself. And then 5 minutes before the meeting starts, you can already log in. And if there are other colleagues there, you can have a chat with them. In this way, you are out of work mode and you're ready to absorb information. And you're also not rushed. Number 4, avoid background noise. Before you enter your virtual call or your online class, make sure to let your family members, your partner, or your roommates know that you have a virtual meeting. In this way, the people in your house are aware and they will be more quiet, and they will also not just enter the room. Number 5, have the right camera angles. Make sure that you are in the middle of the frame and everyone can see you clearly. An unflattering angle is actually when you have your laptop on your lap, because what people see is from down here, and that's not a really flattering angle. When it comes to angles, try to have your laptop on eye level, and you can use a laptop stand for that, or you can place your laptop on some books. A secret to having a successful video call is actually looking into the camera. Looking into the camera is actually equivalent to looking someone in the eye. And you don't have to look in the camera lens the whole time, but definitely when you are presenting or when you are talking. Number 6, and I think this is one of the most important etiquette rules when it comes to virtual meetings, or it's in the top 3. Number 6, mute yourself when you are not talking. Even though you are really silent, your microphone can still pick up minor background noises. Think about noises such as your breathing, coughing, construction, or white noise. So the best is to mute yourself when you are not talking. But at the same time, do not forget to unmute yourself when you start talking. I have had a couple of situations where I started talking, but I did not unmute myself yet. So when you know you're going to say something, make sure to unmute yourself and then start talking. Number 7. Have a neat background. You can actually keep it very simple, as long as it looks neat. So you can have a bare wall like this, or you can have some art on the wall, or you can have a plant in the background. The most important thing is that it doesn't look messy and there's nothing laying around. When it comes to your background, in most of the video call software, you can have the option of having a filter as a background. So you can also do that, as long as it looks professional. Number 8, turn on your camera. If you have a video call with your colleagues and they all have their camera on, you will look bad if you have your camera off. Your colleagues are probably going to think that you did not take the time to get ready in the morning and that's why your camera is off. You can also not say, "I did not do my hair this morning and for that reason I'm going to keep my camera off." That is not a valid excuse when you are in a planned business meeting. Video is still a powerful way for us to maintain human connection. So turn your video on. Number 9, address people by name. We should not forget that when there are several people in a virtual meeting, the person that you are talking to specifically and looking at cannot tell that. For that reason, you need to make sure that you are clearly addressing people by name. Video call etiquette tip number 10. Close all the tabs that are not work-related before your presentation. No one needs to see all the new recipes that you pinned on Pinterest or what you ordered from Amazon. Ladies, those were all the virtual meeting etiquette do's. Now let's look at a couple of the don'ts. Number one, eating. Don't eat when you are in a virtual meeting. Just like a normal meeting, you're not eating during a meeting. So make sure that you eat before or after the meeting. Number two, don't interrupt others. Don't interrupt others when they are talking or presenting. What you could do is use the chat function instead. Number three, don't multitask in the background. So don't be on your phone, don't send emails or continue working, and also don't have a conversation with someone else in your home. Make sure that you are present and you are paying attention to the meeting that is in front of you. And ladies, those were the virtual meeting etiquette tips that I have for you. The do's and the don'ts. If you are ever in a situation where you don't know if something is appropriate, ask yourself the following question. Would I be doing this in a normal face-to-face meeting? Yes or no? And there you have your answer. Now I would like to hear from you. Have you been in a video call where something really funny or really strange happened? Let us know in the comment section below. I have seen some things that were not appropriate for a virtual meeting. I have seen people folding their laundry. I have seen people smoking a cigarette. And I heard people having a full conversation with their partner because they forgot to put themselves on mute. And these are actually normal things that people do in their home. But these are not normal things to do in a business meeting. So if you would not do it in a normal business meeting, don't do it in a virtual meeting. And that was it for today's video. I hope it was informative and that you enjoyed the video. If you did, give the video a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. And ladies, I'm going to wish you a lovely week. And we will see each other again in my next video. Bye!